are at Shashi Prabhu and Associates today, and we would be interviewing Mr. Amol Prabhu. To give a brief about the practice, they are into a lot of segments, specifically entertainment, healthcare, office spaces, and education. So here we have Mr. Amol Prabhu. Sir, thank you so much for your time.
You're welcome.
And we would be really grateful to have insights and recommendations from you regarding the overall scenario.
My pleasure.
So just to start off with, how different do you think is the Indian scenario compared to the international scenario?
So one of the biggest differences between international projects and Indian projects is the level of technical input that goes in a project before the project's closure. A lot of engineering happens abroad, and in India, where the aesthetics is the most important thing, aesthetics is only the final cover on most of the international projects. So a lot of research is done, and when you talk about acoustics in general, immense amount of research and engineering goes in a project about acoustics before the projects are engineered and designed and completed. Whereas in India, very less attention is paid in acoustics.
So how do you see the trends changing over the years in all these segments with particular respect to the indoor environment?
So one of the things, the interesting things that is happening is exposure to the developed countries and the developed nations. People are traveling and designers are coming over here. And because of that, there is a lot of knowledge sharing. Many of the international companies, just like you guys, are coming into our country and they are sharing the knowledge of what's happening. And because of that, the knowledge sharing, people are getting educated. People are understanding the importance of a lot of engineering principles, and they are trying to incorporate those engineering principles, especially the acoustics, into our designs. So that is one of the biggest change that is happening in our field, is the knowledge that we are getting from the developed nations, and especially the research that is happening internationally, and incorporating that into our designs.
Sir, any specific challenges that you see with respect to sound quality, environment, or even acoustics for that matter in your projects?
So one of the biggest challenges that we as designers see is the knowledge and acceptability of the client. Although this factor is changing immensely right now, there was a time when most of the clients were unaware of the importance of acoustics. And that was the biggest challenge we faced. With the growing information and knowledge sharing, clients are becoming more aware right now. But I would say the first challenge that we usually would have is the clients accepting that there is a need for acoustics. The second challenge is the information, the technical information that people like us need to get in order to design spaces integrating acoustics. Third challenge is obviously finding the product to integrate with our designs, because that always is a problem. We as designers want to experiment with the space, but unfortunately are not able to find products to dovetail with our designs. So those are the three challenges that I see usually in designing spaces with acoustics.
Great. So what are the three things that you would like to immediately address as far as an acoustical environment is concerned?
There would be multiple points that we would like to address, but maybe the top three things that I can think of is we would like to see improvement in speech quality, legibility of speech, like for example in classrooms, the improved performance of the teachers and even the last benchers being able to understand what the teachers are saying. In public lobbies, for example, in hospitals that we design in the public lobbies, where the silence is very important, and the reduction of echoes, etc., are very important. Maybe improvement in those areas, and maybe in other healthcare spaces like the operation theater areas, where silence is very critical. Be able to provide better solutions, engineering solutions, to integrate with our design intent. I would like to see improvements or more usage of those things in our designs. Yes.
So do you use any references or tools to mitigate these challenges that you face in different projects?
So primarily we have two types of projects. First type of project is where the clients have the budget to hire an acoustic consultant, and a second one where the clients don't have. So in the first project, obviously it's much easier for people like us, where we present the challenges to the acoustic engineer present on the job, and then they offer us the solutions because they have the necessary tools available at them, and some of these tools are very expensive, so which ordinarily people don't have them. So acoustic engineers take care of that. The second part is obviously when projects don't have budgets, the clients don't have allocated budgets for acoustic engineer, and that's where we try to contract specialists. Of course, basic simple knowledge that we have gathered over the years and the experience matters, and we utilize them. But in addition to that, that's not adequate for us to design the spaces, so which means we need specialized tools, like you said. And that's where we depend on engineering companies, manufacturing companies such as you, to help us with the design solutions, the engineering solution, the acoustic solutions. So that's what we have done in the past. And of course, to validate that, and obviously there are balances and compromises, but start with that point and then develop our design solutions based on the input that we get from people like you.
So a lot of young architects and designers would be looking up to you to have some advice from you. So what would you say?
One of the biggest advice I would give them is have an open mind. Pay attention to the projects that are designed around you. Look at case studies. Study the mistakes as well as the fine points of the design. And have an open mind, and also pay attention, most importantly, to the auditory skill in addition to the aesthetics and the color and everything else along with it. It's a very important part of a building.
I think that is some great advice by Mr. Amol Prabhu. I am sure this would go a long way when future designers would think of their own projects. Thank you so much, sir, for your time and for all your insights. We are really grateful to you. Thank you. So before we wind up the whole interview, we were really fortunate and privileged to have Mr. Shashi Prabhu himself, the man who has seen trends changing over 50 years in the Indian context. So let us hear directly from him how the trends have changed, how the client mindset has changed, or even how the products have changed in all the years gone by.
Today the world is changing, you know, different kind of materials have come. We also started getting, you know, initially from the only housing, we went to the different kind of structures. We went to the auditorium, then hospitals for that matter, industrial building, convention centers. So wherever we go, issue comes about transmission of the sound. And then it has to be pleasant. It should be loud and clear. Every word should be really reached to the last person. And this is where we realize that we require acoustic. And it is not an architect who is really understand the acoustic to that extent. So we started involving acoustic consultant who would really give us some kind of input right at the inception planning stage. And this is we started learning about, say, 15 to 20 years back. Ever since that, any project we come across, we try to use a talent or knowledge of our acoustic consultant. For example, now we are designing hospital, medical colleges. How many people know that in medical college, one class, 250 students sit? Now the lecture is somewhere far off and then he has to use microphone. Now whatever he says, he's teaching. He's using the blackboard, whiteboard, whatever it is. The number of whiteboards are put across. And then students are really taking the notes. Now whatever he says, it should be very loud, not too loud, extended. It should be clear. So that kind of acoustic treatment, now we try to evolve. Now it is not architect's duty 100%. So we started involving these experts into this field, and naturally we come to the end product, which is a different kind of material, right from fabric to acoustic boards to different. And today, there are N numbers of solutions available in the market.
As Sir has just mentioned, the problems and difficulties faced have evolved over time, but so have the solutions. We would really like to thank them for the time that they have given us and the insight that they have provided us. Thank you.